So we've got our frame built, but now we want to add some other elements to the frame. And so we have a few different elements that we use when building these forms in Java, and one is a label. So we're going to have a label and we're going to have a text field. The label is for, generally speaking, for displaying information. Information we don't want the user to type in. We want to display information to the user. And the text field then will be information that the user is going to type in. And so I'm going to create this JLabel. But in order to do that, I'm going to need to import... That's right. We already got that imported, the JavaX.swing library. And so I need to give it a name. So this JLabel is going to be for the, I'll give it a name. A lot of times we'll name our elements with describing what they are. So label name. So I'll call this label name and set it equal to a new JLabel. And then in parentheses goes what I want the label to say. And so this label is going to say, please enter name. That was a unnecessary amount of pause there before I said that. Okay, so please enter the name. This is what it's saying in the label. I'll put a colon in there, so we'll see how this looks on the screen. And then in order to put it on the screen, I need to add it to which form I want it to go to. And so in this case, I want it to be added to the home screen so I can see it. And so what I need to do is say, go to the home screen and add, and then in parentheses, I tell it what it is I want to add. And what is it that I want to add? Well, I want to add label name to the home screen. So I build this label object, and then the label object, this label name object, is what I pass to the add method for the home screen, which is a frame, in order to be able to add the object to the frame. And I believe the default setting when I add it is that it's visible. Let's look at it, and here it is. I've got my label now that says please enter name, and that's on the form. And so now, notice I can't do anything. I can't click, I can't type, because it's just a label. It just sits there for now. And so now let me go in and after I build the label, let me go in and build the text field. And so same thing, JTextField is what it's called, and I give it a name. So this is the text box for the name. And this is a new JTextField. And what goes in here is how many characters I want this text field to hold. How many, what it's determining is the size, because it'll hold more than what you tell it here, but this is how big is it going to be. So if I say 15 as a text field, and then I go to the home screen object and add the text name that I've just created, it didn't do anything. Which is always bad. I mean, you want it to do something, you don't want it to do nothing, right? And so, I think I've got the wrong, let me just see here. So when I create this text field, I think there might be two arguments. Let me just verify this. So the first part is the default text. Let's try this and see if it changes anything. And you can't see it because it keeps popping up off my screen, but there it is. It didn't change anything. Well, we've got another problem here. And let me just try commenting out this adding the name or the label for the name and see what that does. And now that did nothing. Let's see. Well, let's leave that in there and run this again and see if I can type in here. No? Okay. Pause time. Let's try commenting this out. And put this back to the default of just putting the number in. Oh, I know what the problem is. Well, maybe what the problem is. I'm setting the home screen to visible before all the elements are added to the form. And sometimes that causes problems because I told you that the set visible paints the screen much better. See, good learning moment. I had my set visible up here before I was adding anything. And so it worked for the label, but it didn't work for the text field. And so it's always a good idea to add all of your elements before you set visible to true on the form. But now I can type in here blah, and it's a text field, and when I press enter, it doesn't do anything. And so let me go back and add the label now, because we're going to find something interesting here now that we've got that little problem worked out. The label's still added to the screen, but all I can see is blah, the text field. Well, what if I'm going to take and add the label after I add the text field, and let's see what happens now. Now all I can see is the label. And the text field is no longer there. Well, what's actually happening is I have no layout for this form. And so I add the text field, and then when I add the label, it goes right on top of the text field. So they're both there. It's just one's on top of the other, and the only one that's accessible is the one that's on top. So when I change this back to adding the label first, then again, suddenly I can type in the text field, but I can't see the label because, excuse me, the label's underneath. And so how do I fix that? Well, now we get into something that's a lot more complicated with layouts. And there's a number of different kinds of layouts. There's a kind of a, I can't remember what it's called, the directional layout, where there's a north, east, west, south, center, and you can put stuff on the form in the north, and you can put it on the south and in the center. And then there's a grid layout where you can lay it out in a grid. And there's a bunch of different layouts, but there's kind of a default layout that we'll use for these more simple initial programs. And it's called a flow layout. And the flow layout allows us to drop stuff on the form, and it drops the way we read, left to right first, and then when it runs out of room left to right, then it will drop down to the next line and start at the left again. So left to right, top to bottom, and it just puts stuff on the form as you add it, one right after the other, until it runs out of room left to right, and then drops down to the next line left to right, till it runs out of room down to the next line. And so so let's try adding that layout. Now the layout goes with the frame. And so back up here where we're doing all this frame configuration, is where we would want to do this layout. And so we can say go to the home screen object, which is a frame, and set the default layout equal to, and what it needs to be equal to. Now you can go in and set up your layouts and all this kind of stuff, but we, rather than building a layout object, we'll just say we want a new flow layout, opening closing parenthesis. So this is just kind of a shortcut. We could go in and say I want to create a flow layout object called pi equal to a new flow layout and go in and set the options and the layout and everything. But if we don't want to have an object for it, like if we're only doing it once and we're not going to do it again, we're never going to refer to that object again, then we can use this kind of shortcut to say we want to set the default layout equal to a new flow layout, which will set up this flow layout. Now, when we run this, we're going to get an error because it says I don't know what a flow layout is. The flow layout is not part of this javax.swing library. It's part of another library called the java.awt.asterisk library. Now again, asterisk is getting all, but we're going to use more than one method from this awt library. And now it'll recognize this flow layout language. So if I compile and run this again, then we get an error, cannot find symbol, set default layout. Let's see here, set default layout. I don't think it's default. I think it was thrown off by this default close operation. Let's just try set layout. Much better. Okay, so now when we run this, then we get this nice pretty form with a label and then a text field. The label was added first, the text field was added second, and now I can enter a name, and it doesn't do anything yet, but this is exciting. We're starting to see the form come together. We've got this label, or sorry, this frame with a title on it. We've got this label, and then we've got a text field all as part of this frame. And so that's a label and a text field. And what we're going to look at next is a button, and we'll do that in the next lecture. I do feel some ways like Seacrest, because it's like, you know, we're going to say who the new winner is right after this break. So it does fit. So anyway, with that, Seacrest out.